Yo, what's up and welcome back in Rewind! We are going to continue after just those hissing cats. And we are here. Below me I can see the city covered in green. I've never compared it to other cities, but this is a lot of green. The nearby mountains in particular are completely covered in it. In elementary school we took kind of social sciences class called Town. Pardon me guys, pardon me. From what I learned back then, the forest around here is under government control. Which means humans are protecting the forest here. They are indeed. My hair is way too long. I need to get a haircut real soon. Which means humans are protecting the forest here. I already said that one, didn't I? I could even go look for beetles there in the summer. Memories are beautiful. Viva Mother Nature! Viva Mother Nature! I think all children need to go looking for insects at some point. If they don't get used to how icky critters like that move around, they won't be able to calmly deal with more disgusting creatures. Boys need to be able to deal with things like that. Ideally, if something leaps at them, they should be able to go and punch it to the ground. Unfortunately, I didn't get to use those things, so I'm still kind of bad dealing with insects. In fact, I'm like a herbivore that goes "Gah!" the moment I see them. I did go looking for bugs, but I never found any. Russell, I hear something above me. I look up and nothing. I look down and I find a cardboard box at the bottom of the tree. What is this doing here? Is there something above it? I try looking into the tree again. That instant. You aren't telling me that there is something, someone in that tree. And that someone is a girl. What? A tremendous noise erupts overhead. Whoa, what happened? How did she land up in the tree? Just how? Wow. A girlfriend fell from the sky. Her uniform is different from ours, so she must be from a different school. I could tell she was in trouble, but I could not think for a few seconds. The loud rustling of leaves, the light pouring through the tree. A girl with orange hair, riffing around like a fish in a net. I can't tell if this poetic or tragic. Wait, doesn't this mean she fell? Hey, are you okay? I try getting her attention. Huh? She starts wriggling. The branches shake, but she fails to dislodge herself. Her body is stuck in a U-shape between two huge branches, and she can't seem to get up. After falling that spectacularly, you think she'd be injured somehow. Are you hurt? So, no serious injuries. Once I know that, I start thinking again. First, let's rehearse this situation. This cardboard box probably contains the girl's stuff. It's a perfect ordinary box with a moving company logo on it. There's nothing strange about it at all. The girl didn't exactly fall from the sky either. She probably slipped and fell somewhere higher up the hill. But still, there should be guardrails up there. So something must really knock her over. But even then, would she fall over it? Come to think of it, I saw an American cartoon once, where the hero got blown into a dump truck, then leaped out of it along with what he was carrying, and landed at his destination. She must have been trying to do something like that. Hop off the hill and... Hello, you got mail. completing the delivery the moment she landed. Yeah, that would be pretty quick. So, when the dump truck showed up... Ooh-yah! Now's my chance! She managed to jump this far, but didn't quite stick to the landing at the end, I guess. A perfect explanation.
No, it isn't. It isn't at all.
There is nothing logical at this explanation of yours. What the fuck? Although it makes perfect sense, most people would die from that, so it's clearly not right. I stopped being an idiot and looked back up. Dare I ask how you ended up in there? I fell. What? I see. I guess that makes sense. That's normal. No helping it if she fell. Anyway, she can't move right now, so I'd better help. I'll come up there and help. Sit tight. Well, I wasn't planning on looking. But given the position you're in, it's gonna be really hard to not see it. She tries to push her short skirt down. Incidentally, why do girls wear such short shirt? Incidentally, why do girls wear such short skirts if they don't want anyone to see their panties? What the fuck? I couldn't pronounce it. It's kind of hard to climb without looking up, you know, but not much I can do about it. I'd almost certainly see them as soon as I reach the base of the tree. What do you want me to do then? Do you want my help or not? This is going to be fun. I think. This is quite a conundrum. Let's check from some other angles. Crap, I saw a bit of pink. Can't you hide them with something? So you want me to climb up the tree and save you without looking up or in your general direction? How? I can't do it. Since you're giving me no other choice, I'll just move on and pretend I saw nothing. That's impossible. What am I supposed to do? Should you really be talking like that when you're asking someone else for help? Well, I saw nothing, so I just move on. So you can keep waiting and imagining what it'd be like if some old pervert found you, said, "Nice panties," and took a picture. I'm sure it would much worse than letting me see them. Oops, I started talking to myself even though I didn't see anything. I should keep walking while I'm mimicking a certain someone. Namely, a former Prime Minister Koizumi, who used to watch little kids hero shows despite his age. Hey warrior, hey oh hero, this destroy organization, I'm in awe. What? Ah, she laughed. Why? Oh, how did I enable this? So it's okay if I see them? Okay then, nice panties. There. I rescue her without incident. Yep. Fortunately, she really doesn't have no serious injuries. How tough is she? God fucking damn it. Not again. So, how did you end up there again? The truth is, I'm actually a transfer student. Oh, what else could you possibly be? Well, I guess it means this is the girl everyone was excited about.
ようやく見つけてここまで歩いてきたんですが、捕
She's a klutz. Well, that's pretty dumb. Nah, it's fine. It happens to everyone. I reassure her with a cheery smile. Ha, she blessed. I really want to know how they are going to portray this in the anime. I really want to know how they're gonna portray this in the anime. And what the fuck is going on with my pronunciations today? It's really bad. It's really bad at all. I'm really, really bad. So, you spent all morning wandering around town. Nah, it's fine. It happens to everyone. And once more, I reassure her with a cheery smile. Should we get going then? Huh? To school. Like I said, it's fine. Ah, is this your stuff? Did she carry all this thing all around town? I should at least carry it for her. Hump! I put my hands in the holes on each side, raising my hips. This is heavy! Unbelievably heavy! I dropped it. No way. I try lifting it from the bottom. It's still really heavy. My hips start screaming almost instantly. I try handing it to the girl. Hmm? She grabs it without effort. No, I'm pretty sure I'm not that weak. Hold on, hang on a sec. Not too hard. If anything, my arms are stronger than average. Something is not right here. This girl was able to hold that box with her slender arms and wander around town for hours with it. Checking something. Eh, you don't need to. Okay, let's try this. I take the box again. Here goes. Ugh, it's still heavy. I'm just embarrassed. There's no way this box can be heavier if a girl carried it around for hours by herself. They're just excited. No way! I can walk empty-handed while a girl carries this. My pride as a man will not allow it!
I find myself spurred on by a bizarre sense of duty.
Leave it to me! You have nothing to worry about!
But I can't let her take it. It's just not cool. Huh? She pulls on me. I fight back. Oh, this is going to be fun. She puts a little more strength into it and... pop! Ah! The box tears. She loses her balance. Oh boy. She rolled and fell down the hill. Not good! Not good! She collides with the guardrail and falls right over it. I rush towards her. Hey, transfer student! I listen. An answer. She isn't dead. It looks like a three-cutter again. That's thrice in a row. She's really lucky. Actually, she had Betty Prattler. She yells at me. This is my fault. Anyway, she seems fine. And then she falls. More loud rustling noises. Ooh. It's hard to react any other way at this point. Then I hear a loud siren going wee-oo, wee-oo as an ambulance approaches.
Hey, are you alright?
Thank goodness we were driving by. Hurry to the hospital. There's no way you'll be fine after falling from that height. Bring the stretcher. The paramedics put the transfer student on the stretcher with incredible efficiency and carry her into the ambulance. Wee-oo. The siren exhibits the Doppler effect as the ambulance drives away. I simply stand there, agape. I can understand that. Someone rolled down the hill due to you, then falls into a tree, falls out of that tree, and as fourth ambulance personnel were just driving by, putting you on a fucking stretcher and driving you to the hospital. That's on your first day of your new school. Good job. That was quite the transfer student. Transfer students really do make crazy things happen. By the way, cherries. Well, you know, I was able to see them. It's kind of childish for a girl at her age. I can see why she wouldn't want... Ah, her panties. Still. Is she really okay? I don't feel worried. But she did fall from the hill twice. So any normal person would have had broken bones. Though, I guess the ambulance would take care of her. She did seem pretty tough though. Okay. I refocused myself and climbed up the hill. And this is where I will go on in the next episode. Guys, if you liked it, please smash the like button. Don't forget to subscribe down there and leave your comments in the comments below. Don't. That microphone. Leave your comments in the comments below what you think of this episode. Sorry for my pronunciations in this episode. They were quite bad today. But I will work on them. So, yeah, keep that in mind. Guys, I want to say thank you for watching. Take care and bye-bye.